We need to build real low-income housing, finally. LaGuardia did it, as we mentioned today, with NYCHA. We saw what could happen with the Mitchell-Amick housing that was built. The de Blasio administration went to Remy developers and they said, here's the deal. We'll give you more density. We'll give you more access to communities of color through our rezonings if you build me 30% affordable housing. The problem is that that affordable housing is unaffordable to almost every community the housing was created in. The rezonings gentrified neighborhoods and added to the homeless crisis. So we need to have a housing program that actually builds low-income housing, not affordable housing, low-income housing. The fight between de Blasio and Bloomberg as to who was building more quote-unquote affordable housing, it wasn't really affordable. So my plan would do the following. I would access the 1,000 vacant parcels of land in this city that city owned. I would give that land back to the people. I would give it to community-based organizations, provide a subsidy by increasing a progressive transfer, real property transfer tax that would raise hundreds of millions of dollars. I would then say, you build this housing and you build it for the people who need it the most. We move 30% of the people working in homeless shelters into this kind of housing. Second, we also have to stop rezoning only in communities of color and recognize if we're going to integrate our city and build out a new generation of affordable housing, we have to look at as of right development. And I've proposed that 25% of units in as of right development be set aside for affordable housing. So you catch it two ways, in as of right development and in terms of accessing our city owned property. And that's what I would propose. We have to change this and stop fighting on the edges, because we're losing this fight in so many of our challenged economically challenged communities.